no one comes. I gotta get healed up. Oh, I think I've lost a lot of blood. I'm gonna need a stim pack first just to get those white blood cells back up. Alright. The morphine's killing the most of the pain. But I gotta treat my limbs right now. Okay, first my arm, gotta stabilize it. Good. Now, to pick out bits of shrapnel that are embedded in my chest. Oh, shit. There we go. It's better. Okay. Keep your goddamn eyes out for mines, Nathan. Mines and more raiders. Head back the way you came. Get back to Megaton. Rest up. Get ready for another day. Another day alive. Alright. Well, no point leaving these around for more raiders to pick up. If I pack them tightly, bind them up, sling them over my shoulders, I should be okay. Aches and pains. These assholes can keep their armor on, though. Cigarettes ain't a priority. Wait a second. And no. No time to be cute. For a moment, I thought about putting on some of these raiders' armor on, put on a mask, and if anyone else tried to jump me, you know, they'd get second thoughts, but no. I just want to get out of here, safe and sound. Oh, good. Ammunition. Alright. I think, yeah, this asshole here had another large-ass pistol. Could definitely use the ammo. Okay. Just be careful. Get out my assault rifle. Okay, nothing else down here. It's pretty quiet now. Only made one hell of a noise. If there's any more of these assholes left, they must be far enough away, or they don't give a shit. God damn it, where was I? No, not here. Ah, here we go. Now, which way was it, though? Oh, I should try to check that shelter, too. Oh, this must have been where they were squatting. Pink-haired bitch with her shotgun. Yeah. Got any shells on you? Well, a few in your pockets. Okay. I think I saw an ammo crate around here. Yeah. Oh, more morphine, too. Oh, God. My leg and my chest. God damn it. Bite down on this pill. I might need this morphine for something a little bit more critical. More 556. Alright, and a pistol. Can pack that away. What's in here? Oh, thank God. Another stim pack. More morphine. Yeah, that's where I came up. That's where they jumped me. I saw some movement. Shit. There is still someone else around. He hasn't bothered to check things out. It's in here. whiskey. Can't get drunk now as much as I want to. Pack that away. Yeah, she's not moving, they're dead. Alright, might be another bomb in here. That's just great. Oh, there's a pistol in here, though. Oh, wait. And a stim pack. Ugh. Broken bones. Oh, I don't like moving these things. Come on. Fuck it. Let's just walk around it. There we go. My old lunchbox, too. Where I came in. Some more rounds. Nah, nothing. Anything in the desk? Oh, Jet! It's been torn up to shit. I don't know what my chest looks like underneath my armor. But no, you can't act like a jethead, Nathan, alright? If you want to shoot up, at least take that jet when you get back home, okay? We're done for today. Gotta come back here anyway. You can pay him a visit then. God, I hope those... that sign that was... pointed to, you know, the other direction around to Galaxy News Radio. I hope it doesn't end up in a dead end, or I'm gonna be in a bad way. Alright. Have any weapons or ammo on them? A machine pistol. An old hunting rifle. You could use that for repairs. Break it down, maybe. This must have been their party station. Looks like the party's over. Disgusting. Mall outpost, GNR outpost. Maybe these Brotherhood guys didn't tell Three Dog what was going on. Nah, not that. Shit. I think he's down. Not moving, not even twitching. I don't think these things play dead. Oh god, I hate doing this. nudge him with my foot. Hey, no. If he's playing possum, he's pretty good at it. Look at that ugly bastard. Jesus. Just shoot me in the head before that happens to me. Alright, there is an outpost. Unopened. That's good. Alright. Shit. Where am I now? This might have been a bad idea. Nathan, what did you get yourself into this time? Wait. This looks a little familiar, I think. Wait, didn't I pop out here to get to the... Yeah, Chase Avenue. Yeah, and this is where I first met with those Brotherhood of Steel types. Which means this is the way back to Megaton. Ah, perfect. Good. Really good. Glad I managed to find a shortcut, maybe. Although, I think I might stop off at GNR. See if I can't... Ask if any of those Brotherhood types know the way to go. But in the meantime, it's time to go home.
When I got back to Megaton, I was still in pretty rough shape. My emergency treatment in the middle of a hostile wasteland didn't give me the most thorough of healing, so the first thing I did was remove my body armor to see what the damage was. The insides of the legs of my armor were coated in blood, but thankfully, my legs themselves didn't look as gruesome as my armor made it seem to be. The stimpaks that I injected at the time took care of the large lacerations I sustained, but my legs were still heavily bruised, plus small bits of shrapnel still pocked my flesh. I didn't even have to look at the scorched and shrapnel-ridden padding to know that, if it wasn't for that heavy-duty combat armor, I would be dead, no questions asked. I promised myself to remember that every time I donned the sweaty-smelling heavy suit. I took a hit of morphine and plucked out the remaining slivers of the metal from my flesh. I debated on using another stim pack to be rid of the bruises and light scrapes, but decided against it. Best to save my stim packs for an emergency, after all. If I got plenty of rest, my body should heal naturally. But before I rested, I had to get ready for tomorrow. There was no time for despair or frustration. There was work to be done, and plenty of it. I had to get my armor repaired, I had to take stock of my ammo, and I needed to figure out the best way to get to the downtown ruins. I opened the locker I was using to store my weapons, and I was surprised at what a collection I had been stockpiling. After a while of deliberation and counting out how much ammo I had, I settled on 3 weapons: an M14 rifle, a submachine gun most people around here referred to as a grease gun for some reason, and my laser pistol. Of course, I had to get them fixed up. Repairing my armor and tinkering around with my weapons meant that I spent a lot of time in Moira's shop. A few times Moira tried to make conversation, first remarking on how much better I looked and how it was good to see me in the pink. The second time she tried to broach a topic, she wondered when I would feel better enough to continue the research on her book. "Look, Moira, I'll be honest with you," I replied. "The only time I'll be your research assistant again is if two things happen. I find my dad, or I'm desperately strapped for cash. Moira stood there in silence, but she didn't look upset. In fact, a moment later, a determined smile on her face grew as she quipped, "You forgot something! There's a third reason," she chirped merrily. "What's that?" I asked. "Well, I'm willing to bet that, when push comes to shove, you're going to want to help people. And what better way to do that than to assist in the research of a very scientifically minded publication?" That was enough to make me laugh, but not in a sarcastic way. "Yeah, you're right, Moira. I forgot about that. I'll let you know." Moira was a kook. There was no question about it. But damn it, her optimism, her naivete, it was sort of infectious. I finished up what I could and headed to the caravan stop. I had to wait a while to meet up with Crazy Wolfgang. I tried to fix up my belongings as best I could, but I wanted to pay for an expert eye to approve upon my work. While I was waiting, Dokhov's caravan arrived, and it didn't take very long for me to ask to peruse his stock. The good doctor had jet, diazepam, morphine, and, best of all, psycho. I bought all of it and tucked it away. I had to avoid the temptation to shoot up. A part of the compromise I made to myself was that I'd put my drug use in check, only in combat situations, right? Crazy Wolfgang soon made his way along, and for the right price he approved upon my repairs and even fixed a few mistakes I made. He was amiable enough to let me observe him, and I did my best to try and follow along, but he was pretty fast, and the expert junk collector wasn't slowing down just to teach me. That night I relaxed the best way I knew how, diazepam and whiskey. I rested my sore bones and took turns exchanging bad jokes with Wadsworth. It didn't take long to run through his entire humor data bank, and I soon drifted off to sleep. When I awoke, I ate, I dressed, and I checked and double-checked my traveling gear. I girded myself in what I had to do and made my way through the wasteland, back to Galaxy News Radio, without incident. The Brotherhood of Steel still guarded the place, and I took the opportunity to ask one of the so-called paladins for more detailed directions to get to the Museum of Technology. Although I couldn't see his face, he sounded bemused, but he helped me enter the precise instructions, and more importantly, coordinates, onto my Pip-Boy. He reminded me that the best bet was to take the tunnels, and once I hit downtown, that hiding from the super mutants was a better idea than trying to fight them. With that, I returned to DuPont Station. The sooner I did this damn task for Three Dog, the sooner that blackmailing son of a bitch could tell me where my dad headed off to.